Hello students, welcome to your home science class. Today we are going to do the fourth chapter of home science, that is influences on identity formation, socio-cultural context. This chapter rather deals with the social development, the factors that help in the social development of an adolescent, or rather what is social development, how is it formed, etc. Now the first thing that we need to is what is social development. Now, what is social development? Social, according to the definition of the book, it is accepting and adjusting with the approved behavioral and norms and values of the society. Now, see, there are certain norms, there are certain values of our society. There are certain do's and don'ts that is expected by the people in the society. When we react according to those do's and don'ts, that is social development. So what is social development? Social development is accepting and adjusting. So you are accepting the do's and don'ts of society, and you are also adjusting with other people of the society with the approved behavioral norms, the norms which are approved by society. Now these things should be done, these things should not be done. These are the approved things. These are the certain do's and don'ts, certain regulations set by the society. So when you act according to those norms, those do's and don'ts, when you adjust, you accept with those rules and regulations, that is social development. Now, according to Herlock, Herlock is also a sociologist. Now, he said social development means acquisition of the ability to behave in accordance with social expectation. Now, society expects certain things from us. Now, when we behave according to what is being expected by society, then that is social development. Now, it is expected that by our society, it is expected that we have good terms with everyone. So, when we abide by that, we have good terms with everyone, we have good relations with everyone, then we are socially that is approved. But if we keep on quarreling with others, criticizing others, finding out faults with others, that is not accepted. That is one of the things which is not expected by the people of our society. Then that is not a good social development. Now, there are certain social traits of an adolescent. Traits are characteristics that can determine how good your social development is happening. Now, what are those traits? First is social maturity. You are getting more mature. You are learning the approved norms of the society. So, first is your social maturity. Then is social acceptance. What is that? How well you are accepted by the other members of the society. There are certain people whom you can see as soon as they will go in the group will not want that person, the whole group, none of the people in the group will want a particular person, presence of that particular person, then that person is not socially accepted. There may be n number of reasons. Might be he is quarrelsome, might be he always keeps on talking negative things about others, he has a habit of criticizing others, he has a habit of making fun of others. So because of any reason, he might not be socially accepted. So first thing is, you need to be socially mature. You need to understand what is expected from me and what is not expected from me. And then acceptance by society. If you are a good social being, then you will be accepted. You are welcome by everyone. If you are not a good social being, you would not be welcome in any place. Social conformity. Now, what is social conformity? Now, it means when you are conforming to, when you are abiding by the norms that is set by society. You are acting according to the norms which has been set by the society. That is social conformity. So first is gaining maturity. Second is being accepted by the society. Next, third is acting in accordance to the rules set by the society. Fourth is social intervention and skill. These things refer to your good social characteristics like cooperation, sympathy, managing, counseling the situations, and are very important. These are the very important skills. How sympathetic you are to a certain person. There are people, see, it may happen that one of your friend he faced some kind of difficulty or problem in his life. Now there would be a few friends from your group who would say, oh, this happened to you, it is because you did that, it is because you had done in this way, you should not do it that way. Others in the group, they might say, okay, this has happened, see, don't worry, we are with you, we are going to say, or I am with you, I am going to help you out. Now which kind of behavior do you think was required at that time? Definitely the person, your friend, who understood the situation, who sympathized with you and also said and also promised to be with you in time of need. So that is called, that is social intervention. You are managing the situation. You know a friend is in trouble. There is no point finding out who is to blame or where the person went wrong. Rather, according to the situation, the situation demands that you must sympathize and empathize with the person because he is your friend, he is in a trouble. Rather than criticizing him, rather than finding out who was at fault, it is necessary that you understand the situation. Okay, fine, this has happened, I'll be with you, I'll help you in every situation. So that is social intervention and social skill. You are managing the situation. And finally, the last characteristics of social development is participation in social activities. What is that? See, there would be many friends of yours who would go and act as volunteers in puja pandals. Or say, there has been some social problem. There has been, tree plantation camp. Your friend is going and participating in that. Or there may be people who might be raising funds for helping the distressed. Say flood victims or other. That is called social participation. Being a person in the society, you are participating, you are acting, you are voluntarily acting to help others in distress. That is called social participation. So these are the various characteristics that will determine how developed you are, how good you are at social development. Now the next thing we are going to do in this chapter is to find out the development of relationship with various agents of society, like your parents, your friends, your brothers and sisters, etc. So the first thing that comes here in this book is adolescence, family relationship and socialization. Now, adolescence, family relationship and socialization is how well you are adjusted with your family. How is your relationship with your parents, your father, your mother, your grandparents, etc. Right. Now, onset of puberty and starting of physical changes mark the arrival of adolescence. This influences the mental condition of adolescents. Adolescents are unaware of these changes and remain in tension. So, onset of puberty, having menstrual cycle, sudden growth spurt, all these things that has already been discussed, these are the reasons behind various stress and storm in adolescence. They are always worried why these things are happening to us. Now they start looking like grown-ups, but actually from within they feel like a child. People start viewing them differently as their growth is quite apparent. Their growth is apparent. People start expecting mature behavior from them. But mentally they are still they are still immature. So, though the society, though the parents, they expect a mature behavior from them, because of their mental immaturity psychological immaturity, that kind of behavior doesn't come, right? People, they expect them to behave like grown-ups and shoulder some responsibilities. Most of the times, they have not been able to do that. During early adolescence, the interaction with parents is not very pleasant. Adolescents often clash with their parents. That is, they don't have a good relationship with their parents. Rather, the relationship deteriorates. The problem lies with both sides. Parents have not been able to change their attitude to them. Parents, both the parents and adolescents are responsible. As parents, sometimes it happens that we parents are not being able to understand the viewpoint of the adolescents. We try to, we want them to behave in a very mature way, which is always not possible. They still treat them as young children, though expect them to behave like grown-ups. It happens, as I've told you in my previous videos also, sometimes they would say, you don't come fall into this matter, you are not so grown-up. And other times they would say, you are grown-up. and you don't know how to shoulder your responsibilities. You don't know how to do this, how to do that. So this is a there lies the problem. The adolescents often they feel confused. What are we? Are we grown ups or are we still children? They still treat them as young children, though they expect them to behave like grown-ups. Adolescents feel confused and irritated by their ambiguous status. Ambiguous means two kinds of, not one. Ambiguous means by, two things. Sometimes they are treated as young ones, sometimes old ones. I mean grown-ups. Sometimes he feels shy and inadequate in communicating with an unknown people. Then he is scolded for being timid and not confident. On the contrary, when he wants to take his friend on a ride in his father's car, he is rebuffed that he is quite young and could not be allowed to drive a car. This creates resentment in the mind of the adolescents. Right? So this happens. You are not talking with someone you don't know. Then they would tell you, you are grown up. Come on, you should know how to behave with others. On the other hand, if you want to take a ride on your father's car alone, you want to drive yourself, you would be said that no, you are not so grown up. You shouldn't ride alone. So there is the problem, right? Regarding studies, adolescence is asked to decide about their career, but simultaneously warned that there is no scope for an art graduate. The adolescents are thus constantly under the state of stress and pressure. Another thing is generation gap. The parents, they fail to understand the mindset of adolescents because time is changing, and with changing times, the generation, the people, they are also changing. We are not being able to welcome the new viewpoints, new opinions of the young ones. As a result, the generation gap is also responsible for creating a wide gap between the parents and the adolescents. But as time goes by, as the adolescents grow up in the later adolescent period, they understand the condition of the parents, they become more mature to handle the situation tactfully, and thus the relation once again becomes good. Relation with the parents, that becomes good. Now the next thing that we are going to do here is adolescents and siblings. Sibling means brothers and sisters. Adolescents, they definitely do share a good relationship with their brothers and sisters. Often at times when parents, they are at fixed, they are at a row, quarrel with the younger ones. The siblings often come and the siblings often come and act as intermediaries. They try in helping the situation. They act as a bridge between the younger child in the family and the parents. So the brothers and sisters, they always, most of the time, they have a very good relationship with the siblings. Most of the time, they confide in them. They believe, they trust them. And the adolescent, they share their feelings with the siblings. So siblings, most of the time, they are friend, come guide, come teacher, everything. Right? They save them from many difficult situations. Next, we have adolescents and grandparents. Grandparents also are a source of comfort for adolescents. Those of you have grandparents, you would see that often when you are being scolded by your parents, for your rescue come your grandparents. They would come and save you. They would even scold your parents. They see, you shouldn't do this, you shouldn't do that. You shouldn't scold your son like this. So most of the time, grandparents, they are a source of rescue. They're a source of escape for the grandparents, for the children, for the adolescent children. And at times, often because of a wider generation gap, it may also happen the grandparents, they keep on complaining about their ill behavior. They keep on complaining, oh see, your son, he does not know how to talk with the elders, he should not do this, he should not do that. And thus, they are a constant source of clash in the family. It might also happen. Both the things are possible. If you have very good grandparents, they would always support you. If you have, very strict and disciplinarian grandparents, they would be a constant source of trouble in the family. So both can be possible. Now, adolescent and teacher. Teachers also have a great role in shaping the character of adolescents. Right. Most of the time, nowadays especially, the teachers, they share a friend-like relationship with the adolescents. Right. They are a very important part of an adolescent's life. If a teacher is patient, sympathetic, he or she can definitely bring about a great change in an adolescence. He or she has a teacher has a great power, right, in shaping the character of adolescents. Good teachers project their own personality and character as an example for them to follow. So the character, the personality of a good teacher often is often looked up as a role model whom they should copy. A good teacher is often respected as a role model, right? They recognize that the good teacher, they recognize the talents and capabilities of their students and motivate them to develop them, right? They guide and counsel them for future. This helps the adolescents to regain his confidence. Now, adolescents and school definitely, as an institution, it is your second home, and it helps you to socialize, it helps you to be more mature, it helps you to form your own identity, because school is the institution where you spend most of your time other than your home, after your home, right? School is a very important. School is also very important in the life of a child. School is the second major social group after family. Early social concepts are developed in society only. In schools, a child learns adjusting and interacting with his friends, and this adjustment forms the stepping stone of how you adjust with other social people. I mean, other people in the society. They learn leadership, cooperation, managerial skill, sympathy, team feelings, etc. from school. Sex education, which is also a very integral part of adolescent development, is learned that is provided from school. Schools also help develop to an adolescent to learn. Schools also help adolescents to learn discipline, leadership, importance of teamwork, duties towards society, etc. Adolescents and community. Community refers to your own community, the people in your community. That is also a very important part in forming or shaping your character, because it is in your community that you grow up as a person. A child starts learning socially approved behavior from very early age. When a child starts going outside, he starts establishing relationships. These social relationships develop at various levels in family with peers and other members of the community. So in your community, you have your friends, you have your relatives, everyone who helps, with whom you interact every day, and thus you thus it helps in shaping your character. The child becomes conscious of society at an early age. His social concepts develop with encouragement of his family. His attitude towards society depends upon his early social experiences. So whatever he experiences from society, repay back to the other members of the society. Till childhood, social interaction of a child is restricted to its peer group only. With other social members, he has limited social contacts. So when you grow up, during your childhood, in your society, you have communication with your friends only. As you grow up, you start interacting with other members of the community. Now we are going to do adolescent relationship with peers. Peers means friends. Now in the life of an adolescent, peers or friends play a very important role. Approval or popularity in peer group is more necessary than anything else. The peer interaction involved in extracurricular activities also show the organizational operation in adolescent worlds. Now being accepted by your friends, it comes before anything else. Adolescents learn cooperation, loyalty, patience, and abiding by peer groups forms feelings of cohesiveness. Cohesiveness means strong bond, brotherhood in their peerhood. So all these emotional qualities, they are being learned in among the friend group. They develop leadership qualities and get approval from their peers. Interaction and approval by peers give them self-confidence. If they are approved by their friends, if they are supported by their friends, that is a great source of support, that is a great source of self-confidence for an adolescent. As the adolescent approaches late adolescent age, peer group influence starts diminishing. as he grows up, the influence of the friends starts getting reduced. He chooses a close set of friends called clique. Clique is a closer set of friends. When during the early adolescent period, there are lots of friends, all are equal. But as you grow up, you form your own clique. Say two, three people. They are in your own group. There you have a very close association with your own clique. Though they belong to a bigger group, still they yet actually care for these two, three friends. Their opinion they definitely value. They now come more congenial and open to other social groups. They try to include opposite sex members in the group of peers. In the later adolescence, they also welcome people from opposite sex members in their group. Now they try to develop such qualities which are approved and appreciated by the peers of opposite sex. They are now more concerned in achieving in different fields regarding their future and try to be in contact with their peers quite often and discuss about all others. They stand by each other in time of need. Now friends are very supporting. In time of need, you will often see your peers standing by your friends, supporting each other. You are being backed by your friends in time of difficulties. Right? Now, chums. Social circle during this period is very limited. These friends are called chums. They always select few close friends which are of same sex. Now, chums are same sex friends of yours, one or two very close friends. They have common interests, aptitude and capabilities. The interest is very common. Their aptitude, their capabilities, all they share, I mean, all these things are very common in them. They are very loyal to each other to the extent that they can pick up fights for the cause of the friend. For the cause of the friend, they are also, they are even ready to fight for others. Now, clique. This is a small clique has already been defined to you. This is also a very small social group. There might be people who are of the same sex and also other sex. Clique, it can consist of a pair of two or more chums who are of the same sex. They are very close to each other. So, chum is very close. Clique is a little bigger. So, two people, they form chums. Three, four people, they form clique. In chum, chums are your same. The chums belong to the same sex. Actually, they are the member of the same sex, chums. And cliques, they may have members of different sex as well. Males and females, both can be part of a clique. And finally, gang. Gang is a bigger group of adolescents. It consists of generally those adolescents who are not well adjusted in their homes, schools and community. They all start taking part in all antisocial activities. They take more interest in running, playing, running away from school, going to see cinema instead of taking interest in studies. Sometimes they become juvenile delinquents. Juvenile delinquents means criminal at a very young age, that is before 18. Before they attain adulthood. The member of a gang are mostly of the same sex, but during late adolescence, the gang includes member of other sex also. Now, adolescents and their interest in opposite sex, as it has already been discussed, that as an adolescent grow up, he or she starts developing interest in the members of other sex, right? They become drawn towards, they feel a deep attraction towards the member of other sex. In our society, free mixing of opposite sex members is not looked upon as something good. They are often being criticized for mixing with other members of other sex. Adolescents want to have recognition in their own peer group by showing off. They often show off what they have because they think that by showing off, they can be accepted in the society. Adolescents start wearing latest fashion clothes, adopt trendy hairstyle and show off their material possessions such as vehicles, costly watches, etc. Now, development of gender role stereotype. Now, what is gender role? That you are a lady, you should behave in such and such pattern. You should do this, you should not do this. You are a man, so you should not do this, you should do this. That is, development of gender role and stereotyping. From time immemorial in our society, male and female play separate roles and have clear-cut distinction between social status role of both in the society. Society has separate expectations from them with females. Softness, kindness, motherhood and homemaker is attached with females, while with males qualities like bravery, protector, manager, etc. are attached. In every society or society's organization, there are clear-cut and defined sex roles played by male and female members, and they are recognized by their manly and feminine traits. Right? So, a male is supposed to behave in this and this and this way. A female is supposed to be behaved in this and this and this way. So, that this difference is clearly set by our society, and we are expected to behave according to that. Now, boys are expected to go to the market, to go and pay the electricity bill, this and that, while the girls are often expected to do the cooking, washing work and take care of the siblings. This is stereotyping. You are a girl and you should do this. You should be restricted within the home. You are a boy, you should do the work outside. So, these roles are assigned to us from our very childhood. Not only by the society but also by our family. This is all that we have in this chapter. So, from this chapter, please prepare questions like characteristic traits of adolescents. What are the various characteristic traits? Important social traits of adolescents. Then, an adolescent's relationship with various social organizations like family, sibling, grandparents, teacher, school, community, peer and opposite sex members. The most important, very important from this is relationship with family, relationship with teacher, school, friend and opposite sex members. These are very important. Learn the definition of gang, cliques and chum, and then gender role and stereotype. These are the various things that you need to learn from this chapter. That's all, students, from this chapter. Hope everything, all your queries has been cleared. Other than that, also check the questions that are given at the back of the chapter. Thank you for attending the class. Goodbye.